Lion's mane jellyfish are huge. Okay, not that huge. That picture has been proven to be photoshopped, but they are still pretty dang big. They can rival blue whales in length when the length of their tentacles is included, and those can reach more than 100 feet long. The bell of a lion's mane jellyfish can have a 7-foot diameter, and many consider them to be the largest jellyfish on Earth. But let's not forget that there are jellyfish we almost never see, so who knows what else might be lurking in the ocean's waters. Lion's mane jellyfish get their common name from their long flowing tentacles and deep-colored oral arms positioned under their bell. Smaller lion's mane jellyfish can appear orange in color, while larger individuals tend to be more red or purple. Their tentacles are grouped in 8 clusters of up to 150 strands, meaning one lion's mane jellyfish may have as many as 1,200 stinging tentacles. They use the stinging cells of their tentacles to catch prey. Lion's mane jellyfish eat zooplankton, small fish, and even other jellyfish. Once a prey item has been ensnared, it is transported to the mouth on the underside of the jellyfish's bell. Their sting is potent to prey items, but some species aren't affected by it, and lion's mane jellyfish are eaten by sea turtles, georges, fish, and other jellyfish. There has even been research in how wearing sunscreen may significantly help protect against the stings of lion's mane jellyfish. Sunscreen, not just for blocking UV. A lion's mane jellyfish's mouth is multi-purposed. When they're ready to reproduce, usually between March and May, they'll release sperm and eggs into the water column where the eggs will be externally fertilized. From the eggs emerge larvae that will settle on the seafloor and produce polyps that will release adult jellyfish after a little more than a month. Jellyfish are neat in that they reproduce both sexually and asexually. Do you remember any other animals we've discussed that have this ability? Lion's mane jellyfish have a short life of just a year, but in that time they may travel far and wide in search of food. There's some debate in the scientific community in regards to the distribution of lion's mane jellyfish. Some sites list lion's mane jellyfish as a cosmopolitan species, which basically means it occurs around the world in habitats that are appropriate for it. These jellyfish enjoy cool waters in the open ocean. They're typically found in the northern parts of the Pacific and Atlantic Oceans, as well as the North and Baltic Seas. However, there are lion's mane jellyfish, or at least very similar looking jellyfish, who inhabit the waters around New Zealand and Australia. The verdict is still out on whether these are different species entirely or not, so more research is needed before anything can be said with certainty. During their lifetime, lion's mane jellyfish may gather in large groups called shoals. Although these occur naturally, there is evidence to suggest that areas of human activity may be a contributing factor to swarms of jellyfish. And not just lion's mane jellyfish, but, like, all jellyfish. Lion's mane jellyfish have even made it into the mainstream culture in the form of one of the books by Sherlock Holmes's creator, Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. For more facts on lion's mane jellyfish, check out the links in the description. Do you have any jellyfish stories? Give a thumbs up for jellyfish, and thank you for watching Animal Fact Files.